The garden lizard bolts like a green arrow, loosed unintentionally by my leisurely advance. Rashly, it wriggles through the taut wire mesh into the cage of restless marmosets. Skeltering around the walls in a frenzy, it dodges one, avoids another, only to be grabbed by a third. For an instant, there is stillness. It hangs like a stunned fish from a tiny mouth. To my dismay, as it is pulled asunder and eaten, the monkey's eyes flashing around the pen, I see nothing here beyond the ordinary and strictly commonplace. Here in Bahia, life and death are instantaneous. No slow turnaround of the seasons here, where wasteland fires spontaneously in the sun, and biblical rains flood streams of garbage down from the favelas, where teenage boys peer through unglazed windows and prefigure tired old men in identical colored t-shirts. It is always eat now or yourself be eaten. It is make love as the carnivores make love in a land without vegetarians. It is dance the samba and the seething streets for days on end with only snatches of repose. And here, at the wake of the carnivorous sun, as the geckos pad fetchingly across the walls, and the neighborhood dogs give voice in unrelenting choir, only the giant roaches hold still, flapping their antennae at you, until that sudden scuttle straight through your legs like demented tarnished spoons. But you sink into the cool, deep pool of electric fan-assisted nights, compelled to study the art of canine fugue, the time signatures of the singing frogs, and the cricket's genius for polyphony. And as you ponder on the wonder of these, you come to see that though it's drums, it's birimbaos, and slaves traverse the sea, the samba is fettered to the clay, the marsh, and sounds within the sonorous cashew tree.